and welcome to today's installment of Art at Home with Mrs. Beaufeaux. Today we're going to be making some embossed aluminum foil Easter eggs. I have little Delilah here to help me right now. Thea is taking a nap, so I don't think you'll be seeing her at all during this video. Today, to do our project, we'll need aluminum foil, scissors, multicolored permanent markers, a pen, some cardboard, and a coffee cup and a water glass. You'll also need help from Mom and Dad on this project. Okay, friends, here are the supplies that I've picked. The cardboard that I have is actually a box from a stuffing mix that we had last night. So it's a thin cardboard, it's not corrugated. I have a coffee cup that one of my kiddos named Ricky gave me for Christmas. I've got one of our water glasses. You guys saw this kind of glass already yesterday, or maybe 2 days ago, depending on when you're watching this, when we were working on our salt dough eggs. I have a pack of permanent markers of various colors, aluminum foil, and my scissors. I've taken my cardboard box and I just cut it so that I can lay it flat open. What I'm gonna do with my big old coffee cup here is I'm gonna line it up and actually use the bottom to draw, not all the way around, but a portion about halfway through and halfway through of a circle. I'm gonna decide how tall I want my egg to be. I'm gonna put my smaller glass on top, which is my water glass. Can you see what we're doing here? We're making the top of the egg and the bottom of the egg. Then what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take my pen and just do my best. And there's my egg shape. I'm gonna take a couple seconds to cut this out. Now, knowing me, what needs to go on the back of our project? Well, our name, the date that you're making the project, and your class. For the next portion of the project, I'm gonna take out a piece of aluminum foil. Oh, that was kind of a big piece. Let's see what I can do here. And oh, good, both of them will fit. So what I'm just gonna cut right down the middle. And I'm gonna start folding over my egg form. So you can see the cardboard is making sure that we keep the right form. Oh, it's important to have the shiny side out for this project. Shiny side out, so there's one. And then I go through and I can just rub my fingers around the sides to make it nice and smooth. Decide what kind of designs we're actually going to put on our eggs. What's really awesome about working at a Catholic school is that I get to actually tell you a little bit about the history of Easter eggs. Easter eggs used to be a way to send secret messages to your loved ones or friends about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So I'm going to show you some of the different things that the symbols on the Easter eggs are about. If you see a flower, or maybe some leaves on the Easter egg, that's all about springtime and rebirth of Jesus. So we know that Jesus died and he spent 3 days in the tomb and then he was risen from the dead. To represent that, we can do a little bit of a half circle or maybe some scalloped edges like that. Those represent the tomb that Jesus lived in. If you ever see an Easter egg that has a straight line or maybe a couple straight lines around the middle, that's the separation of heaven on top, earth, and death on the bottom. Some other designs that you might see are loops. This is the never-ending love that Christ has shown us. The very last image I'm going to show you is either a sun or sunburst, which could look like this, or it could be a diet, you know, a zigzag line like that. That represents the sun, S-U-N. See how those look like the sun? But they also represent the sun, S-O-N, and the sun is Jesus himself. So these are some different designs that you could put on your Easter egg that actually are a secret hidden message about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So the art technique or concept that we're working on today is called embossing. Embossing is to carve, mold, or stamp a design on a surface so that it stands out in relief. The process of using the markers on the aluminum foil presses down that aluminum foil so that when you hold it into the light, you'll actually see the little divots that are created by the felt tip on the marker.